In today's Dr. C's Tips video, we continue talking about burnout and ways that you can recover from it at home. So in last week's video, we talked about ways that you could recover from burnout at work. So I hope you've been practicing these strategies, because remember, they're only going to work as long as you're practicing them. Why? Practicing them every day? Well, that way it becomes a habit for you. So let's jump right in and talk about ways that you can be doing it at home. So tip number one, have a self-care routine. Yes, this means doing something every single day to disconnect, recharge, and unwind. So you know what they say about self-care Sunday? It means ditch that. Instead, make every single day a self-care day. So this doesn't mean you have to get a massage or nail appointment every single day to fully disconnect. No, it just means taking, say, 10 to 15 minutes, although time can vary depending on the person, to just disconnect. So you want to be able to find something that you're able to relax and be present. So some of these examples could be journaling, it could be painting, it could be opting for a bubble bath instead of going for a shower. It could even be trying a new dance class, gardening, reading a book, just finding something that you love. Because if you don't love it, it's not gonna stick. And if it's not gonna stick, that means you're not gonna do it every day. And I know we're talking about burnout and having too many things on our plate. And right now we're talking about adding something else. So instead of worrying that this is something extra that you're adding to your list of to-dos, instead try reframing that and thinking of this differently as something that's essential and so important for your sanity. Tip number two, reconnect with things that bring you meaning and find a hobby. And if you need any type of buy-in for this one, well, studies show that you are more likely to be happy if you're out having fun and doing things that bring you passion and excitement than actually working more and making more money. Yep. Whereas if you are not having fun, you're more likely to be uninspired in life and allowing your mood to just spiral into a very blue one. So try finding something that brings you excitement and passion in your life. So if you're a very social person, make sure that you are reconnecting with meaning and spending time with your loved ones and your friends. And if they're not close by, all you have to do is pick up the phone. If you're having trouble finding a hobby, well, just take 10 minutes today after watching this video and write down at least 5 activities that you would have loved to have tried or you actually did do when you were a child. What were they? For me, I actually just did this myself, and one of them was archery. I've always wanted to try that and I had so much fun doing it. So after you've written down these 5 activities, try one out this week or next week. And make sure that when you do this, you're scheduling a time for this activity, and you're doing it for an hour. So this could be a dance class, it could be an adult ballet class, you name it, whatever something you always wanted to try and do when you were younger, or you actually did and had so much fun doing it. Remember, the whole concept is you lose the concept of self-awareness and you lose track of time. Almost someone has to tell you, hey, class is over or it's done. So that's really what you want to be achieving when you're doing this activity. Then when you're trying it out, making sure you're sticking to and actually going to the class. So think of this as a very important business meeting and you're protecting time for it. So what's tip number three? Well, that's sleep. Yes, you heard right. We need to be getting anywhere from 7 to 9 hours of sleep each night. I cannot stress this enough. Not sure if you recall from an older Dr. C's Tips video where I talked about sleep, and if you haven't seen it, you can check it out right over here, is that sleep really does greatly impact your mood. It impacts your ability to learn, concentrate, and focus. So if you're not getting this amount of sleep each night, well, then you are tallying up or rallying up those strikes against you for on your mood and your productivity for the next day. So hello, burnout. And that brings us to tip number four and the last tip. And that is really making sure that you're doing these tips for at least 8 weeks daily. And why is that? Well, it really takes at least 8 weeks or 2 months to really activate or reactivate those neural networks in your brain to create a change. So try doing this out for 8 weeks, and if you're still feeling burnt out at the end of this 2 month period, then I highly recommend seeking out and finding a licensed professional. As always, thank you guys so much for taking the time to follow along and watch our Dr. C's Tips videos. Make sure you can hit subscribe right over here so you can stay up to date with all of the latest videos. And then you can also check out older videos right over here. And don't forget to hit a thumbs up and leave a comment below telling me what you liked, if you've been trying out any of these techniques, or if there's a specific video you'd like to see next. I'll see you guys soon.